What is up, you guys? Tana Ashley here, and today I want to talk about fasting. So many people reach out all the time. They're like, what kind of fasting should I be doing? Should I be doing intermittent fasting? Should I be doing longer? What should my windows be? Should I be doing this, this, and this, and this? So I'm going to talk about three most popular fasts, what they're good for, and which one you should be doing. Does that sound good to you? Anyone on here interested in fasting? I hope you are. This was a game changer for me. Anytime I have actually switched to doing intermittent fasting, my weight just falls off. I'm less hungry, I feel better, more mentally clear. Like, I absolutely love fasting, live and breathe and die by it. So let's dive into the most popular topic, intermittent fasting. This one has become extremely, extremely popular over this last year, and that is having a window anywhere from 13 to 15, 16 hours. That is really great to boost your HGH hormone, which will help with you building that lean, sexy muscle, make you look nice and youthful, but making sure that you have better energy, more mental clarity, all of that good stuff. So if you are someone who is struggling with bloating or mental clarity, feeling sluggish throughout the day, give intermittent fasting a try. The best way to ease into that is by, when you wake up, instead of eating breakfast, just push your window back an hour or two, whatever's most tolerable for you. And then just stop eating at a certain time each day. And just make sure you have a space anywhere from, I'm gonna say 13 to 16 hours of a break from food, allowing your body to detox, to heal, and to truly, truly just give it a break. The next fast is autophagy fasting. So this is great because it'll actually kick ass, take names, get those old nasty dead cells out of your body. And you know, this is actually great for anyone that, if you have cancer that runs in your family, this is a great one to actually do. Like once a week is what I would recommend. Just doing a fast for 17 hours. And it really does help with anti-aging, all that good stuff. So I love it. I try to do it like once a week, usually after I've eaten a lot of food for the weekend, because as you guys know, I like to be a pig on the weekends. So, and let's just say you need like a full-blown gut reset. That's gonna be a 24-hour fast. Some people can do that once a week, some people can do that every other day. There's some people who can do that every month. There's some people who only want to do it once a year. So you have to do whatever feels right for you. But if you are dealing with, you know, once again, bloating, stomach issues, not feeling 100%, doing a gut reset is great. So just drinking water, tea, stuff of that sort, just plain Jane, no food for an entire 24 hours. So those are the three most popular fasts. All of them are great for anti-aging, for bloating, all of that, and just to really reset your body and let it detox. So, totally forgot what I was going to say next. Oh, and then talking about my fasting schedule, a lot of people want to know about my fasting schedule, and this is stuff that I actually switch up a lot, because a lot of times people just want to stick to one simple thing, and it's like our bodies are changing, we need to change and make sure it doesn't get used to certain things. So for a while, I was doing my eating windows 12 to 6. So I would not eat anything until noon, and then I would stop eating by 6 p.m. I was still working out in the morning, just drinking my water and taking my vitamins, nothing crazy, and I felt great. I had great results. Lately, I've been a lot hungrier, so my windows have kind of switched up. Some days it's 11 to 5. Some days it's 11 to 7. Just to give my body a break so it doesn't get used to anything. And then weekends, I don't do any kind of fasting. I honestly wake up, I eat the food I want, I eat whenever I want, I eat however much I want, and then back on track on Monday. So that is all my advice for fasting. It is very, very simple. And once you actually start fasting, you're bringing down your insulin levels and all the hormones are coming back into balance. So you won't be as hungry once you do it for a few days. So I tell everyone, try it for 3 days, let me know how you feel. And if you have to, you know, mess with your windows a little bit, mess with your food, whatever it is, just don't give up on it, because it truly is a game changer. So I hope you guys found this helpful. If you guys have any questions, feel free to reach out to me at any time, and I'm always here for you. If you want more details on fasting, I do have a full-blown blog, all on Fasting 101. So I hope you found this helpful. And like I said, if you need anything, please let me know. Bye.